In photovoltaics, it's not the total amount of energy that is important, but the amount of energy per unit time. The position of the sun in the sky changes during the day and with the seasons. Light incidence on our solar panel therefore varies as well. How can we relate the position of the sun to the power incident on the solar panels? The learning objective of this video is to be able to relate the power on the surface of an object to the position of the object with respect to a source and the radiative properties of the source. To that end, we will obtain a basic understanding of the concepts of radiance, étendue, and Lambertian scatterer. Finally, we will use these concepts to discuss concentrator PV, and we will determine the maximum possible solar concentration. For our discussion of basic radiance, we assume a surface S that is irradiated by light. To obtain the total power that is incident on the surface, we have to integrate over the whole surface. We also have to take into account that light is incident from all the different directions. We parameterize these directions with the spherical coordinates theta and pi. The polar angle theta is defined with respect to the normal of the surface element ds. Phi is the azimuth. With these spherical coordinates, we can define the solid angle of incidence denoted by d omega. Therefore, to find the total incident power, we also have to integrate over the hemisphere from which the light can be incident on ds. This leads to this equation. The quantity Le is called the radiance. The radiance is defined as the radiant flux or power per unit solid angle and per unit projected area. The radiance is described by this equation. Dividing the radiance by the refractive index squared, we determine the so-called basic radiance. The basic radiance from a source is a directional quantity. This means that for a certain surface, the basic radiance is very high for the solid angle range from which the sun illuminates the surface. The basic radiance will be very low for any angles outside this range. Since the basic radiance is the directional radiant flux from a source, the power incident on a surface ds can be redefined using the étendue. The étendue is a purely geometric quantity that is a measure of the flux gathering capability of an optical system. The étendue relates the geometrical and angular properties of an emissive source to the geometrical properties of an absorptive medium. The étendue of a two-dimensional system, as shown in this figure, is described by the following relation. The factor cosine theta expresses the fact that the surface element ds itself is not the relevant property. The relevant property is the projection of ds to the normal of the direction. This is also known as the Lambert cosine law. For a three-dimensional system, as we found earlier, the azimuth has to be taken into account. The étendue is then described by the shown equation. Recall our equation for the total incident power. From these definitions, we can see that the power can be defined as the product of the étendue of an optical system and the basic radiance of the illumination source. We just briefly discussed Lambert's cosine law. This law states that the radiance or light intensity observed at area ds is directly proportional to the cosine of theta. Theta is the angle between the direction of the incident light and the surface normal. If Lambert's cosine law holds true after scattering of a surface, that surface is called a Lambertian scatterer. This means that the intensity scattered by area ds observed at any angle is proportional to the cosine theta and as such decreases with increasing angle from the normal. However, for an observer at angle theta indicated by the blue eye, the area dS is proportional to the inverse of cosine theta. Therefore, the power, which is the intensity times the surface area reflected of a Lambertian scatterer, will be the same when viewed from any angle. Lambertian scattering only occurs at an idle diffusely reflecting surface. Back to the étendue, which has an important property. The étendue of an optical system can never decrease. This can be understood because of its link to the second law of thermodynamics. This law states that the amount of entropy in a closed system can only ever increase or stay the same. Entropy is a measure of the amount of disorder in a system. Since decreasing the étendue of a system would decrease its entropy, it is not allowed. This theoretical concept finds its way into solar cells through the use of solar concentrators. A photovoltaic system with solar concentration is shown in this picture. An optical concentrator keeps the basic radiance unchanged or slightly reduces it due to attenuation of the light as it traverses the concentrator system. However, the solid angle from which a solar cell under a concentrator receives the sunlight is increased. We can estimate the maximal concentration of a solar concentrator system. For this estimation, we have to determine the irradiance that is received by the solar cell under no concentration. This is given by the shown equation, where L sun is the radiance from the sun and the omega sun is the solid angle of the sun as seen on Earth. For normal incidence onto the solar cell, the equation simplifies to the product of the solar radiance and the solid angle. Under maximal concentration, the solar cell receives the light from the whole hemisphere. Therefore, the maximal irradiance equals the radiance from the sun multiplied by pi. The theoretical maximal concentration factor is obtained by dividing the maximal irradiance with our standard one. As we can see, the maximum concentration can be increased by a factor of over 45,000. Now, a short recap. We defined the radiance as the radiant flux emitted by a certain source per unit solid angle and per unit projected area. The étendue we defined as the flux gathering capability of an optical system. The étendue relates the geometrical and angular properties of a source to the geometrical properties of a medium. The power incident on a certain area is equal to the product of the basic radiance of the source and the étendue of the optical system. We also discussed that in the case of a Lambertian scatterer, the radiance reflected in any angle is proportional to cosine theta. Finally, we determined that sunlight can be concentrated over 45,000 times.